The loss diagram is a significant output of any PVSYST simulation. We quickly showed you this diagram in the tutorial on the report contents. In this tutorial, we are going to analyze the loss diagram in more detail. The loss diagram is a so-called Sankey diagram. It visualizes energy at different stages in the simulation. The width of the diagram represents the energy flow. The top starts with the input energy, which is the global horizontal irradiation, and the diagram finishes with the output energy, in this case, the electrical energy injected to the grid. To start, let's open the Grid Connected Project tool and open the residential demo. We will look at the loss diagram for variant VC1 of this project. To see the diagram, click on Detailed Results. Then, click on the Loss Diagram button. This diagram represents the entire year of the simulation. You can also view the diagram per month by clicking on the Monthly Values button. In this tutorial, we will focus on the yearly diagram. The top part of the diagram is purely irradiation energy. We can zoom into this part using the toolbar. The diagram starts with global horizontal irradiation, which in the case of Geneva, using our weather simulation, is 1,294 kilowatt hours per square meter. However, our PV array is tilted towards the south and therefore collects more energy than the horizontal. This is why the first step in the diagram is actually an increase in energy. This increase represents the transposition factor from globe hor, or global horizontal irradiance, to globe inc, or global incident irradiance. Following this increase, losses due to horizon shadings, near shadings, and IAM are shown as energy loss arrows. Each arrow value represents the relative loss with respect to the remaining energy at the previous stage. The final irradiation on the collector, 1,366 kilowatt hours per square meter, is multiplied by the total collector area of 49 square meters for getting the total luminous energy available on the collectors expressed in kilowatt hours of luminous energy. Multiplying this value by the nominal efficiency of the PV modules at STC, we obtain the nominal PV energy expressed in kilowatt hours of electrical energy. This value would be produced if the PV modules always worked at their nominal efficiency. Notice that the scale is different between the upper part and the lower part of the diagram. The upper part is expressed in terms of luminous energy, and the bottom part is expressed in electrical energy. The ratio between both scales is due to the collector area and the PV module efficiency. The next two losses are due to the fact that PV modules don't work at STC. These losses are a consequence of the application of the one diode model at each hour of the simulation. The PV loss due to the irradiance level is caused by the low light relative efficiency, which is shown in this graph. Below 400 or 600 watts per square meter, the relative efficiency decreases. This loss may be lower with very sunny weather conditions. The PV loss due to temperature is the well-known decrease of efficiency when the temperature increases above 25 degrees Celsius. This loss may be very high in hot climates. It depends on the temperature of the array, governed by the heat loss factor U defined in the detailed losses. Integrated or insulated PV arrays with low air circulation all around corresponding to low U values, will have higher temperature losses. Other array losses, like the module quality, the mismatch between modules, the wiring ohmic losses, or other losses not involved in this simulation, will decrease the power further. Finally, we obtain the array virtual energy at MPP, which is the total energy from the full array available at the input of the inverter. Then we have losses at the inverter level. The inverter loss during operation is the efficiency loss. This is computed at each hour and depends on the power and possibly on the array voltage. If the inverter is undersized, there may be some loss due to power clipping at the nominal power of the inverter. This is called the inverter loss over nominal power and is the most frequent extra loss in PV systems. You can sometimes see limiting losses due to maximum input current. The losses over nominal input voltage and due to voltage threshold are usually null. A significant value indicates that the sizing is not correct. You have too many or too few modules in series relative to the inverter. In absence of losses in the AC circuit after the inverter, the energy at the output of the inverter is equal to the produced energy injected to the grid. This diagram can be exported in different ways. The image can be copied to the clipboard or saved as an image file. The values can also be copied to the clipboard for use in spreadsheet software like Microsoft Excel. To finish this tutorial, let's explore some loss diagrams of more complex PV systems. This diagram represents a bifacial system. A bifacial diagram adds the energy incident on the PV array after the irradiance is reflected from the ground. This extra irradiance is taken into account before the electrical losses are considered. This diagram shows a system with self-consumption and storage. At the bottom of this loss diagram, you can see the energy provided by the battery pack. You can also notice that the output energy here is split between the energy that goes towards self-consumption and the energy that goes to the grid. The loss diagram is the main result of the PVSYST simulation. Understanding this diagram is of great importance when comparing different simulation results. With some experience, by observing the loss diagram, you will immediately detect possible anomalies in your simulation and localize or identify the cause. To get a more thorough understanding of all possible losses, read the Array Losses General Considerations in the PVSYST help file.